Class is now in session. I'm Bianca Renee and you're watching Bianca Renee Today. And today I'm gonna tell you all the things that you need to know about college that no one has told you before. Now there may be some things in this video that you have heard of, but no one told me and I really wish that someone would have. So even if you gain one piece of knowledge from this video, it'll be worth it. Now to give you a little backstory about me, I actually graduated college 8 years ago. Wow, I sound ancient now. So it's been a long time, but I don't think these same fundamentals have changed. I'm the firstborn in my family. I've been the oldest kid out of my siblings, out of my cousins, so therefore I was the first to go to college. My parents also didn't go to college. My mom became a dancer. She was like touring in Japan by the time she was 18. My dad went to college for like maybe a semester, and then Stevie Wonder called him to go on tour, so he was like, deuces. So my parents really didn't know that much about the college scene either, and neither did like my aunts and uncles. Like, I just really had no one to really talk to about what to do. I just knew that I wanted to go because I was a teacher's pet and I always got straight A's, and it's what you're like supposed to do, right? So I went to Cal State Northridge, shout out to my matador, C-Sun, and yeah, I did some things wrong. First of all, since preschool, we've always been in the mindset of going to school every day. Monday through Friday are school nights. That's just how it was. But no one told me that that changes when you go to college. You do not need to go to class every day anymore. In college, there's usually a Monday, Wednesday, Friday class or a Tuesday, Thursday class. Sometimes it's only one day a week, but it's like a really long class. But there's no class, at least at my school, that required you to go every single day. So my first semester in college, I picked a schedule that had me in class Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. I also learned that Friday doesn't really exist in the college world. That's why Thursdays are considered college night, because nobody goes to class on Fridays. But I was. I picked an 8 a.m. Friday class. Not only did I have a Friday class, I had an early morning Friday class. But obviously, do what works best for you. If you're someone that likes to just have a little bit of school every day, you know, spread it out, that's fine. I'm someone that does not want to be at school every day if I don't have to. And that's me living 8 minutes from campus. If you're commuting to school and live like an hour plus away, please try to condense your schedule to like 2 or 3 times a week. That way you're not driving to campus every single day. That's just too much. So once I figured that out, after my first semester, I did not have a stacked schedule anymore. I was sticking to Tuesday, Thursday. I'm only going to school 2 times a week. So tip number one, don't go to class every day if you really don't have to or if you don't want to. Don't take Friday classes because apparently no one does that in college. And three, pick classes that work for you. Obviously, there's gonna be times where you have to take a mandatory class and only this certain time is gonna be there and it's gonna suck. But if you're not a morning person, you don't like to wake up, you're always late in the morning, stick to like the 11 noon type of classes. Do night classes, whatever fits you and your personality. Now, one of the greatest tips that I can give you that definitely helped me back in the day was ratemyprofessor.com. I wasn't even sure if this website still existed, but I just checked and people are still commenting in 2019. But if you go to ratemyprofessor.com, you actually could see people rate the professors. It's kind of like Yelp for teachers. It gives you all the receipts. So I, being the, I don't know, planner that I am, I did extensive research on my professors before choosing what class I was going to. I was looking for comments like no homework, no tests, just one midterm, one final, no book requirements, all notes are available online, great personality, makes learning fun. Those are all the notes that I'm looking for, and let me tell you, I had the greatest teachers. I don't know if I was just picking like the right professors and the right classes, but college really wasn't that hard for me. I did go to Granada Hills Charter High School, where they take pride in preparing you for college. And I think they really did, because high school was so hard. Like academically, I was doing homework and projects all the time, like nonstop. So by the time I got to college, it was like easy. because there was just no homework. But that's just me. I also didn't go to law school or anything like extremely challenging like that. Shout out to you guys that are. I was a cinema and television arts major, multimedia production, which really worked perfect for me in my YouTube career. I got to learn Photoshop, editing. I got to be behind the scenes on working with cameras, in front of the camera, anything television related, radio, like I kind of touched it all. So that worked out. Which kind of goes to my next point. Really try to choose your major as soon as you start college. I know many people like to go in undecided. They say it's okay, you can go in, kind of figure it out, but you're kind of wasting your time and your money because now you're taking these random classes that might not even go towards your major, and now you just took that class and paid for it for no reason. I think we all want to finish college as soon as possible. I mean, I don't want to be a super senior. I don't want to stick around longer than I have to. So I'm only going to take classes that I need to take. My next tip for you is books. Try not to buy all the books. I learned this way too late in the game. I was getting my little syllabus and I was like, okay, these are the books that I need. And I went to go buy all the books that I needed. And then half the time, we didn't even need the books. We only had to read one chapter in that book for one project. I just wasted so much money. Also, don't buy new if you don't need to. The used books have the same information as the new ones, and you're not gonna read this textbook probably ever again. The better option that I just recently found on Instagram, which I posted in my story, apparently Amazon will let you rent your college textbooks for the semester and then pay for you to send them back. And it only costs $20 to rent some of the books. So someone posted this. I read the comments of this post and people said that it's true. They use it all the time. They loved it. So definitely take advantage of this Amazon book rental system because you don't want to spend that much on books. The sneaky thing that I did that I probably shouldn't tell you guys because then you guys are all going to know the secret, but I would just rent out the same book over and over and over and over and over again from the library. I mean, the library technically has like a clause where you only could rent the book back to back so many times, but no one ever stopped me. So I just literally rented out my textbook from the library for free the entire semester. Worked for me, might as well give it a try. And my last suggestion in the book department would be try to take classes with your friends. One, it's obviously going to be more fun to go to that class with a friend, someone that you know. It's going to be great because if you can't go that day, your friend could take the notes and then you have the notes about the class. And you guys can share your textbooks. You guys can study together. You could borrow the book on one day. They could have it on another day. Another thing that I wish I knew, especially at CSUN, was not to get a parking pass. I was paying like $300 for this parking pass every semester, and one, it didn't even work for the dorms, so I got my first parking ticket ever by using my CSUN parking at the dorms parking, because apparently I needed a dorm CSUN parking pass, which was the same price as the regular parking pass. So then the next semester, I had someone from the dorm buy me my parking pass. That way, because it was the same price, but now I could park anywhere I wanted. So make a friend with someone at the dorms if that's the same policy at your school. But then I realized I shouldn't even be paying for this parking pass because if you do take an 8 a.m. class, no one else is. People do not like to take morning classes. They start sleeping in. They start skipping class. So street parking was like a breeze at 8 a.m. You're the first one at school. You probably can find street parking. So that's what I did. Like, maybe my last year when I kind of figured that out. So depending on where you are, where you live, definitely check out the area for street parking. You might need to walk a little bit more, but you could be saving at least $300 a semester. Because I was the first one in my family to go to college, I also didn't really know how to get in. I was someone that literally had straight A's like my entire life. I was a teacher's pet. I would stress over homework and projects. I was that girl to where if I got an A minus, I'd be upset about it. I know, that perfectionist still lives within me. But if I'm getting straight A's, there should have been no reason why I paid for college. I should have easily been able to get some type of grant or scholarship. I just really didn't know how. My college counselors in high school, they didn't really help me that much. I always felt like I didn't understand like the difference between a state school or a UC. You might not know the difference between a grant and a scholarship and like certain requirements. Like, it's a lot. But if you are in high school, really try to talk to someone that's either been to college, knows the ropes, or hopefully you have a better college counselor than I did. But really try to figure that out as soon as like sophomore year, so you can start preparing yourself for what you need to do, so that applying senior year isn't just a big fast blur of confusion. Now, this next tip is for my curl friends watching. If you have curly hair, you definitely need to wear your hair down, big and beautiful on the first day of school, especially if you don't know anybody and you're going to a brand new campus. The very first person that I talked to on my college campus is still my friend to this day, my friend Ashley, who has the blonde curly hair you guys have probably seen on Instagram. We ended up talking to each other because we didn't know where our theater class was because they changed the room or something like that. But then later in life, we found out that the reason why we were cool with asking each other was because we both had curly hair. You know how it is, so we obviously have a lot in common. If you have curls, you know good and well that you can go to Target, the gas station, the grocery store, the airport, and you could just strike up a whole conversation about your hair because there's so much to talk about. You'll start talking about your products that you use, your routines, and the next thing you know, you're best friends. So do not show up to school on the first day in a bun. You gotta walk in confident. You gotta walk in letting everyone know that you're about to block their view for the rest of the semester and they gotta be okay with it. Claim your territory. And low key, where you sit in class could make or break your semester and or your life. Like, when you really think about it, who do you talk to in class? Usually the people around you, next to you, and then you guys end up becoming friends. That could become a horrible friend, or they could become a great friend, and they could influence your college life. If you don't have curly hair, I'd also recommend bringing extra pencils, extra paper, and gum. These are three things that people usually end up asking for. Actually, do people use paper and pens in school anymore? Those might be antiques now. Don't bring an extra iPad or anything, then people just take advantage of you. We'll stick with gum. Bring something to share, because that's always a great conversation starter. Now, I honestly wanted to make this video for a long time now, but I just didn't know exactly when school started, and now that I'm making this now, I think I'm still too late because many of you have already picked your classes and possibly already bought your books. But for those of you in high school and or going to college soon, take notes or come back to this video later. So these are all of my college tips. I didn't know any of this going in, but I really wish I did, and I hope that this helped at least one or two of you. If you learned something from this video, make sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe and leave me a comment because I'm curious as to what you didn't know. And more importantly, if you're in college or have already graduated, please leave your college tips down below. The more knowledge we have, the better. And make sure to follow me on Instagram at Ms. Bianca Renee. That way you get daily updates on what I'm doing in my everyday life. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching Bianca Renee Today.